Hello students, this is Dr. Manjunath working as an assistant professor in sociology in SMGFGC Kabbahalli, which is located in Chamarajanagar district. In this video today I am going to discuss about socio-cultural determinants of health, particularly about nutrition. So there are many socio-cultural determinants which are determining the aspect of health. So today in this class I'm only concentrating on the nutritional aspects, how nutrition has effects on health, both positive as well as negative. So when there is an undernutrition, how health is negatively determined, and when there is a proper nutrition, when health is positively determined. So today you are going to learn about this, and this video will be useful to this fifth semester medical sociology course of University of Mysore, and it will also be useful to other university students who have the same syllabus. And so let me move on to that. This is with reference to second chapter, constructing illness and health. And I already told you session's topic is about socio-cultural determinant of health, nutrition. And in the previous session, I had discussed about what is environment, meaning of environment particularly. And there were five components of environment, and as well as how environment is a determinant of health. So these aspects have been covered in the previous session. You must have learned these things. We have a learning objective. In this, you can see that here the learning objective is to make students familiarize with the effects of, you know, poor nutrition on health. So what kind of effects a poor nutrition will have on the people's health, so that the students will get to know, and also the students later after learning from this video, they will be able to understand health problems which are associated with the improper nutrition. When there is an undernutrition, what kind of problems they will be facing, so that knowledge they will gain from this video, and also so they will become more aware about socio-economic determinants of nutrition. So what are the aspects which are determining or obtaining or getting an opportunity to take this nutrition? So that is also very important into the sociological students. And so today in this video I am going to discuss about these aspects. So here you can see that meaning of nutrition is important, and how nutrition has effects on health, and socio-cultural aspects also nutrition I am going to discuss about. So here you can see that there are many factors, you know, that determine health. So health is determined by various factors. So whether it is culture or society or even nutrition, environment, and housing and sanitation, like that, there are many aspects of health. So here you can see that in every individual on the earth, so nutrition plays a significant role. So proper nutrition, you know, offers one of the most effective and least costly ways of decrease the burden of, you know, many diseases and their risk factors, particularly when there is some kind of obesity and all those things. So proper nutrition is very much required. So there are nutrition research which is going on. This holds the key to understanding, you know, the causes of obesity, and it's related to comorbidity also. And so it has some kind of nowadays research are going on, particularly about over nutrition as well as malnutrition related. So what kind of diseases they bring, so are being dealt in these researches, which are very, very important. So here you can see that majority, particularly words, you know, disease burden, you know, results from lack of nutrition. So WHO says that almost 20% of this world's diseases are directly related to malnutrition or improper nutrition. So the attainment of, you know, good nutrition depends on and encompasses the entire food supply. So plant and other things will be there. So that proper utilization should be there. Plant and animal foods and their various components are the primary vehicles that provide nourishment to human beings. So that is very important. And nutrition is very, very vital, not only in the growth, but also about development of humans and animals, but also in prevention and treatment of disease. So nutrition plays a very important role in treating the diseases also. Nutrition is also fundamental to the maintenance of, you know, good health and functionality and all those things. So here basic and applied research is going on the interrelations between nutrition and non-communicable diseases and nutrient composition. So they suggest that there is a significant relationship between health and nutrition. So that is very important to understand. So innovative, nutrition research and education provide the basis for solutions to larger, health related issues, allowing, individuals to live healthier and more productive lives. That is very important. So nutrition is very important. What is this nutrition? How it comes? You must be thinking, nutrition is, the quantity and the quality of food that the body receives. The body breaks down the food to get the molecules that it actually needs. So what will be there in the food, what you are going to intake? So there will be a lot of things. Protein will be there, fat will be there, carbohydrates, vitamins and minerals. So these are the nutritional things which are required by any human or animal body. So when a person receives or takes food, so then he or she receives protein, fat, carbohydrates, vitamins and minerals. So these are the aspects where we have to concentrate, and these are the nutritional aspects. So one, any, like particularly your young age, the students must concentrate on getting a nutritional food, because you'll be very active throughout the day and you have to study also. So hence nutrition is very important for your growth, as well as physical, as well as social, mental growth. That nutrition plays a very important role in your development also. So nutrition is refers to, some of all processes involved in how organisms obtains, nutrients and metabolizes them, and also use them to support life's processes. So if a body does not have these things, then the body, what will happen to the body? Body will not work properly. This is the very important thing. Some people you must have seen, always they will be feeling very tired and all. So why they feel tired? Because they are not getting enough nutrients which are required by that body. So hence you can see that once a person gets nutrients, proper nutrients, and he will be working properly. So that is the very important thing. And the positions of bad nutrition can be terrible. So nutrition is very, very important. You can see that there are some people who do not receive proper nutrition, so are becoming more and more sick. ಈ ಒಂದು ವಿಡಿಯೋದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂದಿನ ದಿನ ಈ ಒಂದು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಒಂದು ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕತೆ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥದ್ದು ಏನಿದೆ, ಇವುಗಳ ನಡುವೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ನಿಕಟವಾದಂತಹ ಸಂಬಂಧವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಇಂದಿನ ದಿನ ಚರ್ಚಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈ ಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕತೆ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥದ್ದು ಆಹಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಈ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್, ಫ್ಯಾಟ್, ಕಾರ್ಬೋಹೈಡ್ರೇಟ್, ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್, ಖನಿಜಾಂಶಗಳು, ಲವಣಾಂಶಗಳು ಏನೇನಿದೆ, ಸೊ ಇವುಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಹಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇರಿ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಹವನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಸದೃಢಗೊಳಿಸುತ್ತೆ, ಆರೋಗ್ಯವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ದೇಹವನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕತೆ ಎನ್ನುವಕ್ಕೂ ಮತ್ತು ಆರೋಗ್ಯಕ್ಕೂ ಉತ್ತಮವಾದಂತಹ ಮತ್ತು ನಿಕಟವಾದಂತಹ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಬಯಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ನೋ ಗುಡ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಎ ಹೆಲ್ದಿ ವೆಯ್ಟ್. ಬಟ್ the benefits of good nutrition go beyond weight. It's not only about weight. So it can do lot of wonderful things like it can reduce the risk of some diseases like heart disease and diabetics and stroke and some other diseases also, and it reduces high blood pressures also, and lowers cholesterol, and improve, you know, overall well-being also, and fight off illness. It creates an ability. So particularly in the pandemic period, this corona pandemic period, so one has to improve the immunity system as well as so energy level also to in order to fight the disease. So improve that nutrition also helps to recover from illness or injuries. So that is also one of the major advantage of getting a proper nutrition also. So here you will be wondering, what is the meaning of nutrition? So next slide you can see that. So nutrition is the quantity and the quality of food that body receives. So I already told you, the body breaks down the food and get the molecules that is actually needed. So ee ondo aharavanna sevisida nantara deha en madutte anta helidre aharavanna sanna sanna vagagi odedo adralli iruvantaha micronutrients galanna adralli yavudu anta helidre protein, fat, carbohydrates, vitamins and minerals ivugalanna tegedu namma dehakke nedutte avugalu atyavashyakavadantaddu. Hence, so nutrition has been one of the basic needs of every individual, you know, living on earth. Nutrition is you know, that it's a process which provides energy to the body to perform a lot of activities including routine life. So there are you know, different kind of diseases, weakness and disabilities, so which are very closely related to the intake of insufficient, you know, amount of food nutrients. When people are taking very less nutrients, they are prone to fall in sick. So that's why there is a proverb you must have heard, an apple a day keeps a doctor away. So this is very important. Here also you can see, proper nutrition definitely keeps us away from hospitals. So this is also very important. WHO gives a definition of what is nutrition, and WHO says that nutrition is a fundamental pillar of human life, health and development across the entire lifespan, from the earliest stages of fetus development at the time of birth through infancy, childhood, adolescence and old age. You know, proper food and good nutrition are essential for survival, and good nutrition or survival, you know, physical growth, mental development and performance and productivity, health and well-being. So for all these things, you know, WHO says that throughout a lifetime or lifespan, so this nutrition is very, very important. So it is essential, you know, foundation for human development. Healthy eating, you know, in childhood and adolescence creates a proper, you know, body system. So nutrition also indirectly impacts, you know, academic performance. When you are not properly studying, maybe there will be some imbalance of nutrition also. So when you are falling sick or feeling asleep, there will be a chances of undernutrition. So let me move on to, there are socio-cultural aspects of nutrition. So when one person obtains nutrition, there will be some socio-cultural aspects. So there are, you know, differences in nutrition among different social classes which lead to both under and over nutrition. Illi navu noduvante samajika mattu samskrutika amshagalu kuda obba vyakti paushtikateyanna padeyuvalli pramukhavadantaha ondu patravanna nirdharisutave. Hege anta helidre, ಈ ಸಾಮಾಜಿಕ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಗ ಏನಿದೆ, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ವರ್ಗದ ಜನರು ಉತ್ತಮವಾದಂತಹ ಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕಾಂಶತೆಯನ್ನು ಅಥವಾ ಉತ್ತಮವಾದಂತಹ ಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕಾಂಶವನ್ನು ಪಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅದೇ ಥರ ಇನ್ನೂ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಕೆಳ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಗದ ಜನರು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಉತ್ತಮವಾದಂತಹ ಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕಾಂಶ ಸಿಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಸಾಮಾಜಿಕ ಸ್ಥಾನಮಾನಗಳು ಅಥವಾ ಸಾಮಾಜಿಕ ವರ್ಗ ಕೂಡ ಹೌದು. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು, ಹೈಯರ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೋರ್ ಹೆಲ್ದಿಯರ್ ಡಯಟ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು manual workers and all. So higher socio-economic groups have healthier diets and all. So this is very important. Social class have an influence on dietary intake and health. So information on specific nutrient differences between children of high and low classes may explain us inequalities and identify target areas for, you know, nutrition education. So this is very important. And there are, you know, cultural aspects also. I told you there will be a lot of cultural aspects. Food is directly related to our culture. So culture is a kind of belief or system. which encompasses all the activities, language and whatever we think, dress code and all those things will be involved in this, including the food habits. So culture plays a significant role on what kind of food one has to intake. So this is a very difference, have a difference of foods will be available even in India. So if you go to North Karnataka or if you go to North India per se, the food will be quite different from the South India or South Karnataka, you can see. So this is very important. So here you can see that cultural influences lead to the difference in habitual consumption of certain foods. So, and in traditions of preparation, how food is prepared, so that is depending on the kind of traditions, beliefs and values also. And in certain cases can lead to restrictions, such as exclusion of meat, for example, even some higher castes like Brahmin, Lingayats and all. So they tend to leave meat and some other dietary aspects. So and remaining other castes, so they just easily adopt that kind of thing. And some cultural influences are also amenable to change. When moving to a new country, individuals often adopt to different kind of aspects also. So this is very important when you see that local culture is having some kind of influence on people's dietary aspects. So next we can see that social context also. So here a person who is eating in a group, so he is also having an influence on people's what kind of food they get. So they may get attracted by peer groups, food habits, and as well as advertisements and television movies or Hollywood movies or TV serials and all. So through that also they will be always just tempted to see those videos, and they get tempted to eat and follow those food habits, cultures also. For example, Domino's pizza and all. So when they see advertisements, so they just try to buy the food and they just eat it. So this is the thing which is happening, you can see. So here you can see that peer groups pressure will be there, social support and place where the food they are being consumed also. So even when eating alone, food choice is influenced by social factors, because attitudes and habits develop through the interaction with others. So this is important. So when they are interacting with others, so their food choices are being determined. However, the social influences is very difficult actually to understand, and what kind of food habits are being consumed, but there is an impact on the kind of nutrition one takes. So here you can see cost and income also plays an important. So when money plays important role, you already know that household income and cost of food is an important factor influencing the food choice, especially for low consumer, low income consumers. So when they have a low income, so they just try to spend on what particularly needs and all. So in some places they just survive on only rice, and some places it depends on some places. So if you go to West Bengal and all, the food price is quite low. If you go to Maharashtra and all, food prices are quite high. So it depends on the economy as well as it depends on the living conditions and all. Even in cities, people tend to have a good higher level of lifestyle. But if you go to villages and all, so always there will be some low standard of even with very little money, some people can survive in the villages, but not so in urban settings. So there will be a lot of cost and income plays significant role in determining what kind of food one has to get. So this is also one important aspect, and also education and knowledge and skills, what kind of education one person has. So he will be more conscious about what kind of food one has to take. So eating healthy has become a more recent trend, and eating organic and all has become more trendy. So, or you can say that it has become, people are just following about so being organic or healthy eating, and so just when they are eating, so they are just observing what they are going to intake. So there are some studies indicate that the kind of level of education can influence the dietary behavior during adulthood particularly. So nutrition knowledge and good dietary habits are very much correlated. What kind of knowledge one person has and what kind of food they have, and also information about nutrition comes from a variety of sources. This is very important and is viewed by many places, so they get some good information also and bad information also. However, if a person is well educated, obviously, then he will be having a good nutrition. So this is very important. And next we will move on to a very important aspect. Earlier we saw that positive aspects about nutrition and how it influencing on health and all. So now let us discuss about the effect of poor nutrition on health. So in India, population is too high. And so still it's growing, and because of population explosion and due to lack of proper resources, we can see lots of this food related or malnutrition related problems are happening. So when there is a improper nutrition, so always there will be a problems on the health, particularly obesity. So obesity mainly comes from the overeating or overnutrition. So even in many developed countries we can see that, so obesity is the major problem. Particularly in UK, more than 60% of population is obese. So new rules and regulations are being brought up to control the obesity, but however, so their junk food and burgers, pizza, KFC, this kind of food when they are eating, McDonald's and all, so they tend to get obese. So even hypertension is common among the urbanites, and high cholesterol is quite related to heart diseases also. So there are some diabetics also, and so there will be strokes also, which are, these are the major problems of health, particularly related to this poor nutrition. So this is very important when we see that indina ee ondu taragatiyalli neevu ee ondu poor nutrition athwa ಅಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕತೆಯು ಹೇಗೆ ಒಂದು ಆರೋಗ್ಯದ ಮೇಲೆ ಪರಿಣಾಮವನ್ನು ಬೀರುತ್ತೆ, ಅನೇಕ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂತಹ ಅನಾರೋಗ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಅಪೌಷ್ಟಿಕತೆ ಕಾರಣ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಮುಖವಾಗಿ ನೀವು ನೋಡೋದಾದರೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಒಬೆಸಿಟಿ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಹೈಪರ್ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್, ಸೊ ಹೃದಯಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಕಾಯಿಲೆಗಳಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಸಕ್ಕರೆ ಕಾಯಿಲೆ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಸೊ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಇಂತಹ ಅನೇಕ ಒಂದು ಕಾಯಿಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಡಿಸೀಸಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಪ್ರಾಪರ್ nutrition. So let me conclude that in overall, nutrition plays significant role in determining one's health. So this is very important. So improper nutrition plays improper nutrition affects one's health, and proper nutrition offers most effective and least costly ways to decrease the burden. So this is very important. And there are socio-economic aspects also influencing on nutritional level of people. This you have learnt it so far. And there are many influences on food choice which provide a whole set of means to intervene in and improve people's food choices. So this is very important. There are also number of barriers to dietary and lifestyle change which vary depending on life stages and in which individual lives. So that is also very important. So let me conclude that today in this class you have learned that nutrition is one of the major socio-economic determinant of health, which has impact on health. So when one consumes proper nutrition, so there will be always good health, and when consumes improper or maintains improper nutrition. So always there will be a lot of diseases which he or she has to face. So keeping in this in your mind, you must stick to the proper nutrition. So this is very important. So you have to follow a strict proper organic nutrition which has all types of nutrients, protein, vitamin, minerals and fat, healthy fat and many other aspects. Thank you for watching.